Hello and welcome to this update of Prophecy in the News. I'm your host, Dr. Kevin Clarkson. This update is really less about world events and Bible prophecy. It's a little more personal, if you'll permit me that. Many of you know that late last July, not this year, but in 2015, our middle son, we have seven beautiful, wonderful children. Our middle son, number four child, Joseph, Joey, was found with cancer, a very rare aggressive cancer that was in his eye socket and just beneath his brain. It wasn't in his brain, but the cancer was there in his eye socket. It was a sarcoma. Many of you prayed and you've just supported with your encouragement and words and love and prayers, and I thank you for that. I've not as faithfully kept you updated as perhaps would have been best, but we've always had that link of prayer and meeting together at the throne of God. And for that, I thank you. My son was magnificently beating the cancer, and we were going to march through about another month of final chemo treatments and have a final little surgery and believe we would be cancer-free. But tragically, right after Easter, this last March 27th, he began to complain of severe headaches that were almost nonstop, and he couldn't keep any food down. And as we became concerned after 3 days of this, you know, our doctors said get him to the hospital. So we got him into ER and then with a series of tests and spinal taps and all. Long story short, they believed he had a type of meningitis. They ruled out that it was viral. They ruled out that it was fungal. And so they thought it was a bacterial. And they tried to treat it for a month with very little relief. Nothing was beating it. It may have been an unknown strain of bacteria that we don't know about, but I read some of the doctor's reports late in April, and one doctor was convinced this really wasn't meningitis. It was something mysterious. He didn't know what. But to take you to the bottom line, our son, with his head full of fluid, actually experienced a herniated brain. And I would love to tell you that, you know, he died peacefully, but he suffered enormously, and he was so courageous. He didn't complain about his pain, and every 2 hours he was alternating very strong pain meds, but he just never got any relief, and he couldn't keep any food down. There came a day and a point on a Friday where early in the morning, and his mother and I were with him, where the brain actually just, because of the pressure in the skull, the brain pushed down. And at that point when the brain stem was really dislodged from where it belongs, he lost use of involuntary reactions, and he had to be put on a breathing machine and kept with us for a time. These are family decisions that we're not the only ones who've had to face. We had had talks with our son, and my wife and I have made our wishes known, and it's our belief, and our son knew the Lord Jesus. It's always been our belief that unless there's hope of a recovery that's pretty good, strong, that to keep us tethered here artificially at least is not our desire. And I realize that's a personal decision for every family, so you just take that as our expressed desire and conviction. We had 48 beautiful hours from Friday, Saturday to Sunday afternoon to contact as many of our son's friends as we could through his Facebook and other means, and the hospital room where he was just flooded with a stream of people, and I urged people to say anything they wanted to him. And even though the area of his brain that was governed by speech, it too was probably affected, I don't know. But as a pastor visiting situations like this over the years, I know that the hearing is always with us almost till the end. And regardless of interpreting speech or not, the spirit can sense communication. And I believe the Lord can relay messages. And we felt like Joey, at least from his standpoint of consciousness, was probably like a little kid standing at a playground fence, looking through the fence at all the other kids getting to play and have fun, standing there not quite able to get inside. We felt like that he was tethered here to this earth in his body, but that his spirit was really ready to enter eternity with the Lord. So his friends came and all spoke, and then our family had a very, very tender day on Sunday. We stood around him. We had about an hour worship service. We read the scripture. There's victory in Jesus, I tell you that. Nothing, neither death nor life nor principalities nor powers nor things present nor things to come nor angels nor anything that's created will be able to separate us from the love of God which is in Christ Jesus our Lord, Romans 8. And so at that point, we dismissed everybody from the room but his mother and I and his fiance. And we stopped the breathing. And he was a strong kid. His heart beat 11 minutes on its own. But he passed into the arms of the Lord on April 24th. I want to thank you for your prayers. I want to thank you for all your support. If you didn't know about our own journey here, it's all right. If you lose a child, I've got to say it's the hardest thing I've ever done. And you're never going to be the same. And I shared more of Joey's story in an interview I did with Lynn Lee Oz that's available in our Prophecy Summit from Pikes Peak this summer. And it's one of the bonus CDs in there. And I went into quite a bit of detail about his life and the journey God took him on. You might want to catch that if you have that resource. But let me just say to you that all the prayers we gave for healing, and we believed even up until, really even after his brain had been displaced by the pressure of the fluids, we thought God could do a Lazarus. And I know my God can do anything. But I've realized in a way that I never have since Joey passed, that on the great resurrection described in 1 Corinthians 15 and 1 Thessalonians 4, Paul said, this corruptible will put on incorruption. This mortal will put on immortality. I want to encourage you today, if you're a believer, for every believer in Christ, every prayer for healing is ultimately going to be answered in the most fantastic way you can imagine. And our God is not short. His arm is not shortened. And his strength has not waned. And I will see my son again in the flesh on this earth, according to the promise of Scripture. And I'll spend eternity with him as well. So even though there's sorrow today, Jesus said your sorrow will be turned to joy. And if you do not have that kind of a confidence and a faith and a joy that lets you move through tragedy, I want to tell you, you're not going to find answers anywhere else but the Lord Jesus. So if you don't know him, call on his name today, because you need to have your sin forgiven. You need to be born again so you can be in his family and you can experience this incredible victory. Till then, we're going to keep looking up.